Good day everybody. In this video I will talk about activity and how we use activity to classify plastic soil. So as you already know that coarse grain material like sand and gravel, they don't usually have plasticity, so we don't use activity for this purpose. We can only use it for either silt or clay, something that has liquid limit and plastic limit. So we can also classify soil based on its activity numbers, so it is shown in this table. And what we would like to do right now to look at this example, I'll just look at the example. It says that we're going to classify soil K based on its activity. So where is K? It's here. So this is soil K. And what we're also given is the liquid limit and plastic limit of this soil. Usually we write 45, but it means percentage. So this is water content. We can say percentage, 30%. Okay, so to estimate the activity of soil, what we need to know is plasticity index here. And you already may know that it's liquid limit minus plastic limit. And then we will divide it by the percentage of clay fraction. And if you don't remember, clay fraction starts with a particle size less than 0.002 millimeters. So the whole purpose of this activity is to see if clay is active or not. For example, sometimes we have just a little bit of clay fraction, maybe 5-10%. But this clay has very high plasticity index. So in this case, you will see that the number of activity, you're going to have very high numbers, like probably in this range, and the clay will be either active clay or highly active clay, which is not very good for engineering purposes. This means that most likely this clay is going to swell a lot when it interacts with water. When it's dry, it's going to shrink a lot, so that will give lots of problems to engineers how to deal with that. So let's look at this soil K, and then we're going to estimate activity. I'm going to write it here, activity of soil K. We'll start with the plasticity index. It's liquid limit 45 minus 30, right? So that will give us 15. That's the plasticity index. And now we need to get the percentage of clay fraction. We're going to look at this graph. This is OK. This will be 0.002 millimeters. So everything that goes this way will be clay. So we'll see where, so it's OK here. It will give us about 14%, right? It will be 14 point somewhere here. 14%, that is smaller, finer than this size, which means that 14% will be clay, right? So I'm going to write it here that that will be 14. So we get 15 over 14, and that will give us approximately 1.07. So let's see where it is in the chart. So if you look at this one, it's somewhere here, right? So this means that this clay K is normal clay. So probably that's not that bad. Normal clay is much better than active clay. This means that it has some amount of clay fraction, and it has a plasticity index, which is sort of corresponding to that amount of clay. So it's not very active. It's not going to swell a lot. Okay, so this is how we use activity. That's what it means. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.